In this video, we're going to start talking about the print driver for the Konica Minolta controllers. For the Konica Minolta C3080 and C6100 series, you will see, as it shows in this display here, that is the IC-605 controller. This same type of print driver is used for the black and white AccurioPresses, the 6136 series. And the only real differences between the color controllers and the black and white controllers are the two buttons you see here at the top for the color mode. Obviously, since the black and white presses don't need color controls, those buttons do not exist. Otherwise, the operation and the functionality provided by the driver for the black and white machines and the color controllers are the same. I'm just going to start with this, kind of do an overview of the general tab and some of the customizations that can be done to the drivers. Then there's going to be separate videos that cover some of the other functionality and the buttons covered by the top of this video. So what we'll see here is a default installation and configuration of the general tab. The general tab can be configured to meet your needs to show the items and functionality that you would like to have on the front page without having to go dig through the rest of the print driver properties to set those up. So, a few things that you'll notice here is I've got some drop downs that let me choose some paper size, some paper trays, some finishing functionality, number of copies. Then there's a section towards the bottom here where we've got some big buttons for quick print. And you can tell at this point that the machine is set for printing two-sided just because that button is in bold font here. One of the things that I'll mention when you're using these quick print buttons is that as soon as you click on one of these buttons, it applies a few settings to the driver and immediately closes this interface down. That's nice from the functionality of just having one button to hit. If I wanted to make a booklet, I can print a booklet simply by opening these properties up and clicking the print booklet button, at which case it applies some settings and returns back to allow me to make that print job. The drawback to that is, if I needed to change anything else, I'd have to go through and make those changes before I were to click that button. So in many cases, what operators will do is configure this general tab so that these buttons don't appear. As you'll notice across the top, I've got these buttons for different functionalities. The little blue arrows on each side of these buttons means that there are a continuation of more buttons that are available there. So in this case, I'm going to come over and I'm going to look at my configure tab. When I come to the configure tab, the first thing you'll notice is that it has an acquire device information, which will ask the machine what accessories are configured on it, and you'll see that it's got a green arrow and finishing devices are populated in here. This is a good thing to do to check to see if you've actually got a communication established with the machine and the print driver. What I'm coming here for, though, is to customize the general tab. So I will look at driver options. And in driver options, I've got a button at the bottom here to configure the general panel and another one to customize the panel order. First thing I'll do is click on this configure the general panel. And this is going to come up and show me the options that are currently selected are going to have a check mark in the front of it, and it also shows me what the panel looks like. So as I mentioned, what a lot of people do is, I don't necessarily want these quick print buttons. I'd rather have just features on this front page. So I'll deselect the quick print button. You'll see that they go away. I can say that I'd like to see the two-sided. I'd like to see imposition. I can scroll down, and as you scroll down, you can see that almost all of the options that are available within the print driver sections of the buttons up here are represented. So I could say that I would like to also have my paper size show up in my general tab. I want to have my paper profile show up in my general tab. And as you'll see, it's adding those to the list of options that are available in my general tab. for my purposes, maybe one of the first things I want to check is the paper profile. And as you see, I selected that and I am clicking the button, and that will move my paper profile up and down using these buttons here. If I wanted to look at some of the other options, maybe I want to take my two-sided button, and I'd also like to have that up at the top. I can select two-sided, move that button up. I can select my imposition. I can move that up, and using these buttons, you can see that I can turn on and off the functionality that I would like to see on this general tab and configure it so that it shows the options in the order that makes sense for the way that I'm going to think about these jobs when I go to program them. When I click OK, you'll see that it just returns back to the general tab. I now have my selections that I can make, so I can choose my imposition. I can choose the paper profile that I want to use from the paper catalog entries. So the things that I would commonly want to look at on the job when I set those up, I can set those from this front page. I'll return back over to my configure button and we'll look at the customized panel order. So you'll see all these buttons up at the top. This is what I'm customizing with this option. So when I use the panel order, I can come in and say, I don't want to have the authentication show. I don't use marks or stamps or forms. So I can turn those pieces off. I can also say I'd like to have my workflow button move to a different position. And as you look here, you'll see that I'm clicking this and the workflow is moving its way across. And I want that to be on my front page. When I click OK on that, we come back and we will see that now I've got my workflow button up in the middle of my selections on the first screen of buttons so that I don't have to scroll to the back to hit that workflow tab. We'll discuss what this workflow tab allows you to do later on. If I come back over to configure, in customize panel order, there is also a default button which will turn everything back on and replace it back to its default conditions. I'll set that back for now. The only other thing that I want to discuss at this moment is I've also got a version button here. And on the version button, you'll see that it shows me the version of the driver, but one of the other things that it does is it has a web connection link. If I click on the web connection link, it brings up a web browser page that actually connects me to the print management software web page on the machine that it's connected to, and this lets me manage the jobs in a single place for the machine. I can adjust the properties, I can reprint jobs, I can deal with jobs that have been placed on hold or whatever. This web page is generally available just directly from the machine, so it's something that anybody on the network that's able to reach that machine could access. It's just that within the print driver here, this web connection gives you an easy link into that. One other item that I will point out while I am looking at these screens is it's something that appears across the bottom of all of the buttons. It's this favorite settings option. This is something that appears on the Windows drivers. There's a slightly reduced functionality that's available on the Mac drivers. The Windows drivers is what I'm going to be covering in this section. So you'll notice here that this has got a little arrow so I can look at the presets. These are all presets in the driver that you can use to store common job setup. So we were looking at the default settings. If I come to select an option that's pre-programmed that says that it is full bleed booklets and I click the load button, you'll see that many of these options have changed to the settings that are appropriate for that. If I were to come in and choose different settings and perhaps I just wanted a one-sided with a punch, what I would do would be select one of these locations where I wanted to store that. I'll enter a name in for what I would like to store that setting as, and I will hit the save button, and now you'll see that single-sided with a punch is listed as an option. When I want to go back to default settings, once again, I can just select it from that list and save that. There's also an option. If you click on the little arrow next to load and save, it will say load from a file or save to a file. If you wanted to save that as a file that someone else could load that file in and start using that same preset, that gives you the functionality to be able to do that. So I could save this file out to my downloads folder. I could share that file that it created with another user via email, and they could come in and load it on their workstation and have that same preset on their desktop.